My name is Stephanie Vlachos. I'm a postdoctoral scholar in Todd Nystul's lab here at the UCSF Parnassus campus. The specific area of research that I'm interested in and that I've been studying is how stem cells talk to their neighboring cells to maintain them in their home, what we call a stem cell niche. We work with Drosophila, and I'm specifically interested in the intestinal stem cell. And this largely pertains to all types of cancer, so not just cancers that affect the intestine, but we're interested in how cancers first form. And if there is a link between cancer and stem cells, how does a mutation in a stem cell talk to its neighbors and affect neighboring stem cells to then kind of start off cancers before tumors even develop. I am one of two Canadians in our lab. I grew up in Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. My mom was admin, human resources for various companies. My dad, who was Greek. We had a family restaurant growing up because all Greek families have a restaurant growing up. So from a very young age, I was kind of put to work and was shown that you need to work hard to get what you want. And science was always something that really interested me. I knew I always wanted to be either like a nurse or a doctor, and I don't know if that was my mom's doing, but I just kind of followed what I was always curious in, and that always happened to be cells and science, and just kind of by default ended up in a lab at my old university during my undergrad. And as my old supervisor would say, that I just never left. In the project that I've been working on, I've kind of had to pioneer myself, teach myself a lot of things, use the resources around UCSF. So networking mainly, asking for a lot of help, and I think things took some while to get going, but now, a few years in, I can say we've made some progress and are pursuing putting together a paper in the next few months, so I think things are pretty good. I usually roll into the lab depending on the day. Sometimes it's as early as 8, sometimes it's as late as 10:30. But usually it starts off the same way, just kind of getting set up here, get started on some reactions, or I have to travel to the Mission Bay campus to pick up some samples. So when I collect samples, I have to put them in a form that's really easy to analyze. And so for some of the questions that I'm trying to answer, I have to get the tissue as flat as possible because it makes imaging a lot easier, so it's not, a wavy piece of tissue, but something that's flat. And everyone else in the lab, we try to do things right away, so as soon as we harvest some tissues, we fix them in the way that preserves the structure of the cells, maintain the proteins that are there, and then we stain them for various antibodies. And depending on what we're looking at, we prepare those tissues in a specific way. And we have to also be very delicate because the tissues are quite fragile. Just the possibility of getting new results that are intriguing and allow for more questions to be asked. That's what keeps not just my interest in coming into the lab every day or keeps me excited to come into the lab every day, but just that keeps me interested in the project at all and science at all. Finding results that provoke more questions and expand our brain. I've learned so much in the last couple of years just from working on my own project, and that's really exciting to me. And I guess for as much as we know about cells and stem cells and the human body, we still know very little. And as results come and technology develops and progress, we can develop new tools that's really beneficial to the medical science field. So whether it's new drugs or new technology that allows us to detect cancer or any other disease earlier, I think that's where the benefit lies. Maybe a decade from now, 5 decades from now, our work will have contributed to something greater, and that's exciting to me.